to worship the Lord. Perhaps the Lord helped you this week in some way. Have you been able to feel His presence and bring Him home here? Maybe you can experience His comfort. The Lord can sometimes bring the gifts to help us as we finish up our series on values and principles and business and Jesus is above all and for all. That is the key to this world's problems. The world may not accept the fact that we have walked down, but the truth of the matter is that Jesus is the answer. And the more that society has tried to relegate God to a box, we see that He is important. We believe and are praying for God to have an entire worldwide revival that will turn this place upside down. Because Jesus is above all and for all. He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except by me. There's not many ways, there's not many roads, there's one road, one way. And it is Jesus Christ. And so today, we want to end up our series on our values way, focusing in on the fact that we pursue miracles over the mundane. Now you see, have you ever experienced a miracle in your life? And you know, leave them up for a minute, leave them up for a minute, don't be afraid. You know it wasn't luck and happenstance, but it was God. Beyond the shadow of a doubt, it was God. See all these things? God is a miracle-working God. Give Him praise in the house today. So we see, especially as Pentecostals, that we are to expect the unexpected. Amen? In that, a lot of times we as Christians, we look back on the good old days, but I'm telling you, it doesn't have to be in time. Today can be tomorrow's good old day. The same God that worked miracles and was moving in the good old days is still alive. He has not changed except yesterday, today, and forever. And so it's good to focus in on this idea of pursuing miracles over the mundane. And of course, I am a person of great faith, but I'm not looking around here. I'm surrounded by Roman soldiers. Luckily, I see some angels in the crowd, so I hope that I'm keeping my eye on the star of over Bethlehem, whatever you say. I want you to know that I think that the church and all the children should have received a coloring page on the back of that page. You can keep track of every time I say miracles. Miracles, 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 and you can't make any of them. So, in Acts chapter 2, we see that the disciples, the apostles, they had been told by Jesus on the Mount of Olives to go and kill you in Jerusalem. Do you be imbued or clothed with it was Satan that used it as a purpose of conspiracy. But when these two parents of mine conspired with one another and said that the goodness became silent and coming in, not only did I receive the word of education, but also the bills of inspiration, but also I think the thing I hated the most was when they said, go and sit in a chair and think about what you've done. So even from an early age, that was not good at what to do with me. Wishing I was not thinking about all the things I can't be doing. Now, in my age, what used to be a punishment is a gift. If you take me, don't sit in the chair, I'm like, hallelujah. I don't know how long I'll think about what I've done before I think about the back of my eyelids, but I will go sit in the chair and it's fun. But as they were in that room,